Let's start our English class for today. Let's talking about again about jobs and occupation, but we're talking about especially about jobs, about work. How to changes works nowadays. Yeah, you know the word reinvented. Yes. So we're talking about today. What about jobs changes, ya los cambios que han sufrido los trabajos. Let's start for today about changes at work, yes? ¿Cuánto han cambiado los trabajos ahora? Changes at work. This is our topic for today, ya ese sería nuestro tema del día de hoy. Changes at work. For example, some people, for example, about you, yeah, let's talking about you. What did you do the last year? Talking about students, yes, about students. For example, previous knowledge here, yes, about you, yes, changes at work, previous knowledge. Yeah, let's talking about you first here in those two questions. Question number one, what did you do before the COVID-19 pandemic? Yes, what did you do? Let's talking about you, about students, last year, what did you do last year? Chicos, ¿qué solían hacer ustedes el año pasado?
Ir al colegio, para cambiarnos.
Al colegio.
Esperar a que sea la salida.
Solían utilizar uniformes, ¿no?
Estar sin mascarilla.
Hacer formación.
Mascarilla, hacíamos formación, iban al campo.
Hacer bulla.
Muy Dios, sí, mucha bulla.
Cantar en el salón.
Cantar en el salón. Ya. Yeah. Salir del salón, ¿no? Esto, la señorita Adriana.
Estar fuera en la puerta. Salón,
estar en la puerta.
Llamar okay. A los compas de tu otro salón.
Yeah. Okay. Lot of things. Yes. What did you do before the COVID-19? So, let's write in here the word used to. Yes. I used to. Esta palabrita, chicos, la voy a subrayar con... A ver, no, la voy a sombrear. I used to. Esa palabrita used to, yes, es un auxiliar también del pasado, yes. Significa que yo solía hacer. I used to. What did you do, yes, before the COVID-19? So, I used to. Yes, podemos decir que solía ir pues a la canchita a jugar, ¿no? En los playgrounds. ¿Qué más solía? Ir al colegio, ¿no? I used to. Right in there, please. Two sentences. Yes.
Go to the school.
Yeah, I used to. Very good. Go to school. Yeah. I used to go to school. Another one. Go to the playgrounds, ¿no? A distraerse. I go to a park. Ya, yeah, ahorita el parque está cerrado, ¿no? Fui a Marques y todo sí, está cerrado. Sí. Everything is closed. Yeah, I used to go to, no everything, but just talking about park, talking about distractions places, ¿no? Talking about distractions places, it's closed. Like movies, closed. Parks,
ir a bailar, mis
closet, discotheques, closet, so it's closet, yeah, not now, I think later, but what about beaches,
la playa,
yes, so I heard two days before that the president said, so that
mandó cerrar la playa, mis.
No, but we can go now, but just 3 days a week. Just Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, I think. solo han permitido ir los lunes, martes y miércoles, I think. You can go now. Yes, you can go now to the beach, but just those 3 days, solo en esos días, yes? Just in those 3 days. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. So you, in the future, so in the summer time, in January, February, January and February, you couldn't go. Yes, you must go. Está prohibido, chicos, ir en esa, at weekends, los fines de semana, in January and February, en febrero y enero.
I miss.
Mm-hmm. Yes, just 3 days a week. So let's continue here, please. What do you do now? Si ya cambió, pues I used to go to school, but now, last talking about present, yes? The present simple.
Virtual class.
Yes, I study by virtual classes. That's right, virtual classes, online classes. I study by virtual classes. Mm-hmm. I study by virtual, not
right. Usar mascarilla.
Yes, use mask, virtual. I study by virtual classes.
Ahora jugamos Among Us, Miss. Among Us jugamos.
Yes. You play a lot of by computer, no? Yes. I study by virtual classes. I use mask. I use a mask. I use a mask. It's not correct. Mask. Yes. I use mask. And you chat a lot, no? You chat online. So let's talking about jobs, yes? And previous, here we have some vocabulary about jobs, and then we are talking about how the year changes. ¿Cuánto han cambiado estos trabajos? Yeah, observe please those pictures, yeah, and write them. In number 2, number 3, number 4, and number 5. For example, number 1 is A, yeah? Number 1 is A, doctor. Number 2 is B. How do you say vendedor ambulante in English? How do you say vendedor ambulante in English? Do you know?
No, Mitch.
¿Han escuchado, chicos?
De verdad, no.
All right, seller. Vendor, yes, seller, vendor, with double L, con doble L, yeah, seller, vendor, yeah, it's there, it's here on the reading after, here, sorry, it's here. Yes, let's underline, a ver, voy a subrayar, let's underline, seller, or también podemos decir street vendor, yes, seller también es vendedor, en este caso vamos a poner street vendor, yes, vendedores ambulantes, ven que estoy subrayando, street vendor. All right, complete there, please. A street vendor. ¿Lo vieron? As you can see, please.
Amen.
Yeah, street vendor. Vendría a ser el vendedor ambulante. And what about the other one? Street vendor. What about number 3? How do you say mesera in English? Mesera in English.
Waitress.
Because it's different, yes? In female is waitress. In masculine is waiter. Boys are waiters and girls are waitress. Waitress. Cambia, chicos. Aquí el sustantivo en varones y en mujeres, chicos y chicas. Yes. En boys es waiter. Y, se escribe waiter. Y con W, con W. Y en las girls sería waitress con T. Waitress. A. Yes. A. Way. E. Way. T. Yeah. T. R. Way. I'm sorry. Waitress. Waitress. Ay, no se puede escribir. Waitress. Yeah. Mesera. Number four. How do you say una persona que te lleva la comida a la casa?
Rappi, mi rappi.
Delivery, yeah? Delivery person. Delivery. Delivery person. Delivery. It's Luis. Luis, no me subraye. Delivery person. Delivery person, I think, is here in the... is here in the reading, yeah? Because we're talking about today, yeah, how do you change it in Rosalinda and Felix. Here is it, delivery person. Delivery, delivery person, yeah? Delivery, delivery person. Is there. Delivery person or delivery people, sorry. En esta cuestión, delivery people. And number five, how do you say bombero in English?
Firefighter.
So please, help me please to reading about Rosalinda's time to change, hora del cambio, time to change. And you please reading? Volunteer to reading, please.
Yeah, you and me.
Yeah, thank you. Rosalinda Velázquez.
I cook for my customers the same way I cook for my family.
Yes, thank you. Ese es su lema de Rosalinda, yeah? I cook for my customers the same way I cook for my family, ¿no? Cocino para mis clientes, customers, ya, yeah? Vendría a ser los clientes, customers, la misma forma, la misma manera que cocina para su familia, the same way. I cook for my customer the same way I cook for my family. That's right. So during the lockdown, Rosalinda adapted her business, yes, to the new normal. Let's read more about changes she made to her routine. She used to go to the, vamos subrayando los, lo que solía hacer antes. She used to go to the market, yeah, she used to go to the market every morning to buy all the ingredients needed to make anticuchos, But now, ¿qué ha cambiado, chicos? Acá hay una palabrita de un conector. Conector de consecuencia, ¿no? But now, yes, pero ahora, but now, who goes to the market? Her son, yes, su hijo. Her son buys the ingredients because he doesn't want her to get sick. Yes. She used to go to the market, but now her son buys the ingredients, right? Another changes. She used to, otro cambio que ha habido en su trabajo. She used to, yes, she used to open her food stand at 11 a.m. Ella solía abrir, yes, su stand, su puesto, ¿no? A las 11, yeah? She used to open her food stand at 11 a.m. But now, a ver qué cambios hay ahora. But now, she arrives at 8, okay? A.m. to disinfect everything. Ahora llega más temprano, at 8. To disinfect it, everything, it takes a lot of time to do that. Her customers used to, and other changes. Sus clientes solían, yes, used to sit around the stamps. Yes, her customers used to sit around the stamps. Los clientes solían sentarse alrededor de su puesto, yes, to eat. But now, ¿qué ha cambiado? But now, they take the food. Pero ahora lo llevan, ¿no? Solamente despacha para llevar. But now, they take the food home, all right? So, Rosalinda misses her coworkers. Ya, esto también es un punto importante. Rosalinda misses her coworkers. Yes, Rosalinda extraña a sus trabajadores. Coworkers. Rosalinda misses her coworkers and customers. Extraña a sus clientes y a sus trabajadores. Yes, but she knows they have to stay home to be safe. Street vendors are responsible, hardworking, and extra careful. When they disinfected that good word they used to prepare the food. Yeah? Entonces, chicos, ¿cuál es? Aquí también hay algo muy importante que subrayar. Las cualidades de los street vendors. ¿Cuáles son las cualidades, las características de los street vendors? ¿Qué son, chicos? Responsibles. Hardworking. And extra careful, ¿no? And extra careful. Y son muy cuidadosos, yes, and extra careful. Esos son los puntos importantes, chicos, a tocar, yes. Underline it, please. Underline it. The three changes. Los tres cambios que han habido. The three changes. And the characteristics of the street vendors. Y las características, yes, street vendors. Did you do it? Chicos, ¿pueden encender su cámara para ver si están trabajando? A ver, no veo a nadie. No sé si están allí. Además que este trimestre no me han enviado, chicos, todos no me han enviado sus evidencias, ¿eh? Yo no me voy a estar inventando sus notas. ¿Ya? Estamos trabajando en clase. Trabajamos en clase y ustedes simplemente tienen que enviarme su evidencia, ¿ya? El que no me esté enviando quiere decir que no está trabajando. Solamente entra al Zoom a escucharme y nada más. ¿Y qué estoy aprendiendo? Yes, time to change. Okay. So, did you finish? ¿Ya subrayó? Yes. ¿Qué pasó aquí? Mucho, ¿qué fue? ¿Qué es esto? Me confundí. O sea, ¿para eso entra al Zoom para estar chateando? Ya voy a tomar las evidencias, chicos, ¿ah? Ya, quiero ver que desactive ese chat, please. Sigue ese chat. Bueno. All right. Let's continue about, yes, what about Felix, yes, what about Felix? During the lockdown, Felix's job at the restaurant in Iquitos has changed a lot. Let's more about his new job. A ver, ¿qué ha cambiado con Felix? Felix used to be a waiter, solía ser un mesero, but now he's a delivery food, yes? He delivers food, sorry, to the customers' homes in the bike. Before the pandemic, he used to start at work at 12 p.m., but now he makes up 8 in the morning and delivers food. Yes, and delivers food all over the city for it. Felix misses his co-workers and the people at the restaurant. People at the restaurant. But he likes riding his bike to different places every day. Delivery people, las características. Have to be organized, quick and very careful in the traffic too. Felix says, things have changed a lot this year, so I have adapt and changes. Yeah? Han cambiado las cosas y tiene que adaptarse. Yes, adapt to changes. Adaptarse a los cambios. Okay, voy a dejar aquí, chicos, para que trabajen ustedes. Yes, complete. Ya hemos leído. Complete Rosalinda's Felix profiles with information from the text. Yeah. For example, what's his or her, what's her occupation of Rosalinda? What's her occupation of Rosalinda?
Yeah, cocina. Tiene su restaurante, supuesto.
No, but el nombre in English. She's a, how do you say, vendedora ambulante? She's a vendedora ambulante. Hace un ratito lo vimos.
Waitress.
No, esa era la mesera.
Algo con vender.
Street.
Vendor.
Street vendor. Yeah, she's a street. She's a street vendor. She's a street vendor. Where does she work? ¿Dónde trabaja, chicos? Where does she work? She works at the
market.
At the market, yes, at the market. Yes, she works at the market. What about, what did her job changes? What did her job change? ¿En qué ha cambiado su trabajo? Lo hemos subrayado en la parte de arriba.
Lo abre a las 11 de la mañana.
Ya, yeah, ok. Una de ellas, póngame, hemos subrayado tres cambios que tuvo ella. So she used to buy at the market. Ella solía ir a hacer las compras, but now she, her job, her son, yes, her son helped. Uno de los tres cambios. What does she misses? Qué extraña, también lo hemos subrayado. She misses, yes, her co-workers in English. She misses her co-workers and customers, ¿no? Extraña a sus trabajadores y a sus clientes. Yes, in English, write them in English, please. Yes, she misses her, she misses her co-workers and customers, yes. What are the characteristics of street vendors? También lo subrayamos las características. What are the characteristics of a street vendor?
They are hardworking.
Hardworking. They are hardworking.
Extra careful.
Extra careful. Son más cuidadosos ahora. Extra careful. And
responsible.
Responsible. That's right. And responsible. What about Felix? What about Felix? What is his job or occupation now?
Waiter.
Waiter. Chicos, pero estamos hablando de los cambios. ¿En qué cambió su trabajo? Era. Solía ser un mesero, pero ahora ¿qué es?
Reparte comida.
Delivery.
Person.
Delivery people or delivery person. Yes, he's a delivery people. Yeah. What is his job or occupation? Delivery people. Where does he work? ¿Dónde trabaja, chicos? Where does he work? He works at the restaurant. What is his job changes? Escríbame uno, algo que ha cambiado, en qué cambió su trabajo. So he used to work at the like a waiter, and now he's a delivery person.
Delivery,
no?
Person.
Yes, un cambio. What does he misses? What does he misses? Extraña. The same, no? His co-workers and his customers, ¿no? Y los clientes. What are the characteristics? Ajá, the characteristics. Allí verifican cuáles son las características. Please, this is for you. Yeah, number four also is for you. Match the picture to the description of the correct jobs. ¿ya? Unen las imágenes con las descripciones con los nombres correctos, ¿ya? Yes? Number one is the example, for example. Number one is police officer, ¿ya? Police officer says, I keep the community safe. Community safe. Yes, this is the police officer. So number two is Sam?
Four.
I take care of people
in hospital.
That's right. Number three is?
I help my students learn new things.
Yeah. Number four is? Number four?
I catch fish in ocean or lakes.
Yes. And number five is?
I build houses with my own hands.
That's right. Yeah. So number one is police officer. Number two is a nurse. Number three is a teacher. Number four is a fisherman. And number five is a construction worker. Yes, albañiles. Constructions worker, fisherman. And here, please write in the name of the jobs that you do before. Complete the description using the name of the jobs from the previous exercise. And the one, yes. So number one, number two, number three, number four. What about the changes of used to catch fish every day, but now he rests on
fisherman.
Yes, the fisherman. Number two, used to teach in classroom, but now she teaches from home.
Teacher.
Number three, that used to monitor a few patients every day, but now he monitors a lot of patients.
Nurse.
They used to wear only a helmet at a construction place, but now he wears a mask too.
Constructions worker.
And number six, it's for you. And number, it's for you, create sentences using the information in the chart from the example, yeah? For example, here. Tengo que completar, chicos, ya, estas oraciones, number one, number two, number three, utilizando este cuadrito de acá. ¿Qué palabra tengo que utilizar? Used to, así como el ejemplo, ya. The street, for example, the street vendor, ya, estamos el primero, ya está, the street vendor, tengo que utilizar used to, y luego escribir lo que está en el cuadrito. Used to let her customers eat at her food stand. Les permitía a sus clientes comer, ya, allí a su alrededor, ¿no? Stands. Y ahora, ¿qué palabra luego tiene que ir? ¿Qué conector?
But now.
Yes, but now. Y el new habit, su nuevo hábito. Habit, ¿ya? Nuevo hábito. But now she, no se olviden, chicos, es present simple. De ponerle, de aumentarle al verbo, ¿ya? Porque estoy hablando de la tercera persona, en este caso la letra S. She gives, eso es, ¿ya? She gives them the food to take home, ¿no? Para llevar la comida. What about mechanic? Aquí tienen, chicos, los pasos. Past habit, que solía ser, the mechanic used to, tienen que poner ahí, the mechanic used to, ¿ya? But now he talks the firefighter, past habit. The firefighter used to wear, yeah, but now he wears, and the next one, the delivery people used to, aquí completan con esta oración, used to, but now he rides, yes, sigan las indicaciones. Yes, para completar sus oraciones. Ok. Y here, chicos, una pequeña tareita. me escriben otro cambio que haya ocurrido, yes, en alguna otra profesión. Hoy día hemos visto about mechanic, doctor, nurse, fisherman, waiter, ya hemos visto esos cambios que han tenido. Me escriben algo similar, yes, a este cuadrito que está arriba, pero en una oración, ¿ya? Change it, how change it about. Describe a new job, yes, how changes. It can be a family member or another, make sentence about him or her. All right, así como hemos visto arriba, ¿qué solía hacer y qué hace ahora? Yes, utilizando la palabra used to, but now. ¿Alguna pregunta, chicos? Me escriben a mi personal si desea alguna ayuda. All right.
Sí, Miss.
Thank you very much, students. That's all for today. Goodbye, students.
Yes,
take care, please.